Blender 3.0 introduces phase one of the Asset Manager project. This is an extremely exciting feature that'll change the way we use Blender. This video gives you an impression of what it is, why it's important, and some basic instructions on how to take advantage of it. The Asset Manager allows us to easily manage, store, and reuse models and materials. Phase 1 introduces local library management, allowing you to organize your files on your local computer or network drive. If you're interested in the rationale behind the system and its design, check out the articles on the Blender development blog linked below. Let's walk through some of the basic concepts that you need to understand before getting started. To understand what assets are, you first need to think about what a blend file is made of. A blend file is a database of multiple data blocks. Data blocks are the primitive objects like models, textures, materials, armatures, and several others. When you're planning to reuse components of a blend file, you are in essence sharing bundles of data blocks. The same goes for when you share a model on Open3D Lab. When you create a project page, you give it context and meaning, looking at the collection of data blocks. What kind of object is it? What is it for? So in the Blender Asset Manager, assets are curated data blocks that are meant to be reused. They are enriched with additional metadata like preview thumbnails, categories, and author information. As a practical example, a chair asset is made of a mesh object data block, a material data block, and a texture data block. Together, they form a single cohesive asset that can be reused. In turn, an asset library is a directory that contains blend files with these reusable assets. As mentioned, in the current implementation, these only exist in folders on your local PC or network drives. You navigate and manage your asset libraries through the asset browser that is newly introduced in Blender 3.0. You can easily drag and drop assets from the Asset Manager into your scene. And since the data blocks are reused instead of duplicated, they are more storage and memory efficient when rendering. So to summarize, an asset is a reusable data block with added meaning. An asset library is a folder containing assets. And the asset browser is how you can browse assets inside Blender and use the assets in your scene. If you come from a Source Filmmaker background, the asset libraries are like the Source Engine's mod directories, like UserMod, where you copy your downloaded models into. And the asset browser is like the model picker inside of SFM. In the context of Open3D Lab, the Asset Manager provides additional meaning and management to the pre-made blend files that the site currently provides. You would no longer need to manually find, link, and append from blend files, but could just copy models into your asset library and browse inside Blender if and when you need them. And in future Blender versions, you may even be able to browse the Open3D Lab and SMUD-based asset libraries from within Blender. For me personally, this is extremely exciting, and I can't wait for the team to implement the necessary features in the coming years. Subscribe to the channel for future developments on this. For now, let's look at how the local libraries work. Make sure you've updated to Blender 3.0. Once open, you might first want to configure the location of your library. The asset library paths can be found in your preferences under the File Paths tab. You can have multiple local libraries. I've configured a few different ones on different locations. One is a network drive. Files stored on network drives will usually load slower than stuff stored on a local SSD or HDD, so make sure you factor this into your choice. This will of course depend on your home network and the speed of the network drive. Once registered, the blend files in your asset library will be scanned for assets. This can currently take a while, depending on the number of blend files and assets contained within. This will improve in future versions as the Asset Manager matures. Let's make some assets. I downloaded a pack of props from SFM Lab that I wish to turn into assets. Link to the asset pack in the description. I'm going to import these into Blender using the Source IO add-on, Check the video about importing SFM models for more information on this. Importing all the models at once will freeze Blender for a bit, but it gets me all the files into the same scene. After cleaning up the models and disabling everything but the first entry, it's time to start making assets. Let's open the Asset Browser panel. To the left, we see the library sources. This will be set to Current File, because we're editing the blend file that will contain our assets. For now, let's keep it set to that, and look at how we can create our assets. We have a massive list of model objects in the outlier. Let's start by looking at the first one. The model isn't the best, but we can improve it or edit it if we want. For now, it will serve as a good example. Let's select it, right-click it, and select Mark as Asset. You should now see a new entry appear in the Asset Browser. Select it and open the right-hand panel with the N key. This should get you some options. Let's change the display name, set a description, and set our name as the author. We can also change the preview image. By default, Blender will render its own thumbnail, but we can pick any image we want. We can also add tags to make searching easier, although their utility is currently somewhat limited. If you want to mark materials inside assets, you can do so from the material list on the specific object. Repeat these steps for all the items you want to be able to reuse, and organize your files in a way that makes sense to you. Once we're done organizing our assets, it's time to save. For our files to show up in the Asset Browser, we first need to save them in the directory designated as our asset library. How we organize files in the Asset Library directory is up to us, and won't reflect how the files appear in the Asset Browser. You may also have noticed that there is another list below the Library section. This is where you can create asset catalogs. These categories can be useful to organize assets in a blend file agnostic way. For example, you can group characters and props, or you can make it specific to a project. It gives you some flexibility compared to tags, which are currently not as useful. Once you've saved your asset in the Asset Library folder, it's time to open a new Blender instance with a new empty scene. If we open an Asset Browser panel and switch the selected library to the library we want to save our files in, we should see our asset catalog and our newly created assets. We can now build a scene with our existing assets by just dragging stuff into the viewport when we need it. Do note the little drop-down at the top of the Asset Browser. This will determine the method used to include the assets into the scene. If you're not already familiar with the Blender concepts of linking and appending, be sure to check out Crude's article linked in the description. This setting will determine whether assets are linked or appended to your current blend file, which may or may not be desired depending on your project. Also note that there are currently some limitations to turning characters into assets. Characters with advanced armatures may not import cleanly due to visibility and scripting issues. Hopefully, this will be ironed out in future versions. So that's a quick overview of the newly released Asset Browser in Blender 3.0. It's a really exciting feature that makes scene building a lot easier. Hopefully, it makes Blender more accessible to new users. Future releases of Blender will expand upon this functionality to allow users to connect to online 3D asset libraries. That means you would be able to browse and download assets from Polyhaven, Polygon, and Open3D Lab directly from inside Blender. Place them in your scene within seconds. I'm really excited about the potential that this feature has and look forward to the possibility of integrating it into Open3D Lab and SmutBase. Like this video if that's something you would want to see in the future. Subscribe to the Patreon to support the site going forward. If you want to thank the Blender developers for their work and ensure Blender's continued development, be sure to head over to the Blender Development Fund and chip in. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.